Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes. And Peter. Going to a service call. We've been going to this guy's house for, I want to say, about a good solid 10 years. He's got a colonial house. He's got a HVAC system with a zoning. Got two zones. First floor, second floor, with those big giant dampers that run off a Honeywell relay, zoning relay. And he's got air conditioning issues. Strangely enough, every year, like clockwork, usually in July or August, we're there because of an air conditioning issue. So let's see what's going on. And I know he's got, I think he's got a big dog, but it's a sweet dog. So we'll get, hopefully we'll get some video of the doggy. It's a nice doggy. We like nice doggies. We're not a cat family, right? We're not a cat family.
I have one, but
I know you have pussy.
I like
you have
dogs.
A pussy cat, don't you?
I like dogs more.
Yeah. Do you like pussy cats, though?
She's a nice cat.
See how I can get away skirting, like, the seven deadly sins that you can say? Seven deadly words? Pussy cats. But we're going to stop and get some Taco Bell on the way there, though. Does that sound like a plan?
Sounds like a plan.
Okay, let's go. How excited are you right now?
Very excited.
Okay, you got to put in pipe duck.
Maybe
one word. Pipe D.
Pipe
dog. Pipe dog. Pipe dog sucks. That's you. Oh, pipe dog ass. No. Fuck out of here. Okay. Head to the cashier. It's a... If I recall correctly, a golden doodle or a yellow lab?
Oh, those are cute.
Yeah.
I love yellow. Want to check in, please?
Sure. It's, I think he's a big boy, though. I remember he was a puppy.
Aren't labs nice, though?
Yeah, of course, they're good dogs.
Not very nice.
But I think he was,
Oh, Mike.
What's going on, brother?
What's up? Everything good?
I'm good. We can talk about the puppy.
Stay here.
Hey, he's a golden doodle. That was right.
Hey, back up.
Oh, he's cool. He's cool. Come here. Hey. See, you are a mini golden doodle. Yes, you see, yes, you are.
Big
yeah. For some reason, I thought you had a big dog.
Yeah, I give it.
Oh, you had the yellow lab, right?
Yeah.
What's going on today?
This,
besides him.
My problem is when I turn this on.
The thermostat.
The one upstairs won't work. If I turn the one upstairs,
yes.
This one, the bottom, start working. The air start coming up from the back.
So if you turn on this floor, what happens?
The one upstairs don't work. When I turn this floor, this one.
And upstairs is on.
Yeah.
So upstairs is on.
But it's not. There's no air coming.
No air coming out of the vents.
No. Yesterday it was very hot.
So how do you get? What do you do to get it to work? Nothing, that's why I'm here.
Nothing. I'll try and I couldn't do anything. But what I'm seeing, I know we have two zones,
yes.
But I see three lights. Oh,
okay, three zones. So what's up? Are they both on right now?
No.
Okay, so let's.
I turn this one on to try to see if I can get some up there.
So if I just turn this on, it works?
This might turn on sometime, but sometime it doesn't. I mean, not this one, but you can't hear the fan working.
So you just want to play. Okay.
You can hear the fan. Hey, Zuko, stop it now. Stop.
Hey.
Yeah, you can see this one on.
Okay.
But you can feel the air here,
yeah.
But you don't feel it upstairs.
All right, so right now we're off.
Yeah, put it off so I could.
So now upstairs is cool.
Because it's not that hot outside.
Well, okay, let's go upstairs. His thermostat, 76 set for 72. Right? Cool. That's that. It's 76 up here.
All right. First floor thermostat is on. Air is still coming out of the second floor system. So something else is wrong here.
First floor.
Yep.
First floor is blowing out air as well. Here's the outdoor unit and... Oh, it's not frozen. Discharging a lot of heat. We're condensing there. Peter, let's get the cleaner. Let's turn this off, get the tool bag. Let's wash this unit. All right, so Peter and I took off the top of the unit and we used by refrigeration technologies. It has the Venom pack. This is the brightener cleaner. I couldn't get any more, just the other ones, the yellow ones that I used, but we washed and cleaned the condensing coil and we fire it up and we're checking our pressures right now. And we're still waiting for it to stabilize, but we have 75 on the low side and 175, 177 on the high side. That's where we're at right now. I don't know if we have a TXV or not, but let's let this stabilize and see what's going on, because I want to address 76 degrees on the second floor and it's set for 72. Zone 2 is in calling. We were upstairs measuring, well, the first floor, the vents, the diffusers, which are all on the floor, 57 degrees, right? We went upstairs to the second floor hallway on top of the landing. We got eventually went to 57 and a half. Then I went to the attic to make sure all the ductwork was intact, make sure the damper was open, which it was. And then we went to the thermostat and it was, we're checking out the programs. 6 a.m. Monday through Friday, it's 72. 8 a.m.
From all except one day, it's 72 all day.
Yes. 75 and correct. So at 8 o'clock in the morning, we went down. Anyway, the thermostats weren't, programming wasn't an issue, but we checked the airflow in the master bedroom because you're a little bit taller than me, and it wasn't really dropping. And then we went down here, and the zone is off. All right. See, thermostat. Set for 72, reading 76. And there's no air coming out of the vents. All right, so RC, G, and Y all connected. Now we're forcing a call for heating, cooling with fan. All right, let's go to the furnace control. And now we're calling. See that? Now we're calling. You know what that means, Peter, right?
That thermostat?
What was that?
That thermostat.
Exactly. See, you're learning. Aren't you glad I gave you another raise? Well, the first raise. See, you earned it. All right.
Good,
right? Thermostat. Yep. We're going to turn it off. Good. And see what Daniel says. Peter.
It's off.
Okay, I'm going to turn it back on. It came back on?
Yeah.
All right, so we just turned it off, turned it back on, and the air is moving. And air coming out of vents.
Excellent.
Well, look at that, Peter. We didn't find the problem right away.
Yeah.
But, you know, we went outside. We went to the condensing unit. You know, we did our due diligence with that. I knew it was condensing, you know, but I wanted to make sure that coil was clean before we continued diagnosing. Didn't have to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, instead of being in and out of there and maybe possibly not finding the problem, at least, you know, we did due diligence, and we know the coil's clean, because it hasn't been cleaned in a few years. And then we go to the thermostat, and we're testing our pressure, our temperatures coming out of vents, and I'm thinking about the programs on the thermostat, because I noticed that hold was not displayed on the display of the thermostat. So then I was reviewing the programs. And, okay. And then we found that there wasn't any more air coming out of the vents. We went downstairs, saw that the zone wasn't on the zone panel, and bypassed the thermostat, and it turned on, so we confirmed a defective White Rogers, the 1F80-361 thermostat, which I replaced with the Series 80. And now he's happy. And I went like this, and then he went, teep. Yes, for you.
Thank you.
You owe me $10.
Thanks.
All right, guys, do your due diligence. You know, leave no stone unturned. Get the job done. Thanks very much for watching. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.